So I have a lot of issues with this concept of letting profs say what they say, whether it's in an academic way or not, because in fact, you're in violation of what I would consider is conditions of learning.
A committee mandated by the Quebec government to investigate academic freedom says classrooms should not be safe spaces. One course lecturer argues saying offensive words like the N-word isn't conducive to better learning, and classrooms should move from safe spaces to brave spaces.
I think we need to be moving from safe to brave space with parameters, with understanding that we want people to feel comfortable. At the same time, your comfortability doesn't come at the expense of my discomfort. People have to understand critical reflection on what they say and the intent and the impact it makes on others. And so when you change it from a safe to a brave space, this is where people have to pay attention what comes out of their mouth. I didn't say police themselves, pay attention, because what I say to someone else does have an impact on that person.
The report recommends the government instate an academic freedom law in universities that would include policies in each establishment. The committee also recommends against universities imposing trigger warnings, which would warn students about potentially offensive or traumatic classroom material.
I'm not quite sure why this group is promoting, like I said, the removal of safe spaces when we have diligently worked on keeping our campus physically safe, gender safe, sexually safe, and now why should it not be race safe? I feel any student deserves to be in a class where there is a critical exchange of ideas, but we also have to understand, like, our constitution, like our human rights charters, that whatever there's a right, there's a responsibility.
Dr. Jafralie argues that language matters and using offensive words can harm students and even impede their learning.
It just seems that the pendulum is being swayed in a way that's a little bit too pro-professor. And I think as professors, we have to understand that to create the learning conditions. And if learning conditions are violated, and AKA a student's not feeling comfortable, then how do we expect them to absorb the material that we're presenting? The very definition of a critical argument is finding different ways to say your point of view without using language that is derogatory or inflammatory or hurts others. So I would challenge professors like myself to find other words to discuss these topics and to still raise these poignant issues, as opposed to finding academic loopholes to use words that are harmful.
In Montreal, Brittany Henriques, City News.